Hello and welcome to In Goa 24/7. I'm Rosario Lopez Fernandez with today's top stories. Back in 2008, Goa grabbed worldwide attention when the forever 15-year-old Scarlett Eden Keeling of British descent was raped and left to die. The Mumbai High Court finally declared its verdict and found Samson D'Souza guilty, while Placido Carvalho is found not guilty in this heinous crime. The details of the sentencing will be given on 19th July 2019. Scarlett's half-naked body was found covered in 50 injuries on Anjuna Beach on February 18, 2008. Police initially declared her death was caused by accidental drowning, but her mother, Fiona, fought for a second inquest.
Sir, just a few
words. See, accused number one, Samson, is convicted. Accused number two, Carvalho, is acquitted. The matter would be heard on Friday on punishment.
There were six sections which were applied on these two accused. The first section was section 354, which is outraging the modesty of a girl. The second was section 328, which was giving narcotics. Then there was section 304, part 2, right, which is causing death in knowledge but not with intention. Then there were sections related to the Goa Children's Act, where this girl, who was a minor and who was in their presence and in their control, rather than protecting her, these people, they gave her narcotics. They took off her clothes, they assaulted her sexually, and they killed her. So that conduct brings them under the purview of the Goa Children's Act. And accused number one, which is Samson D'Souza, was found guilty on all counts. This is on the same evidence which has been gathered on the trial over 10 years and on which they were acquitted.
So one more accused.
Sorry? Regarding Placido Carvalho, he was found not guilty on his conduct. There wasn't enough evidence to find him guilty.
On the quantum of sentence?
Yes. So today the verdict was announced. Day after tomorrow, which is the 19th morning, the court would hear on the point of sentence, on the mitigating circumstances. And after that, the court would consider and announce a sentence.
So were you able to convey the judgment to the mother?
No, not as yet, but I think I would convey it as soon as possible. I would need to convey it because this incident, this loss has weighed heavy on her heart for the last 11 years, right? And that weight today must have been lifted substantially. It would be finally lifted when she hears the sentence on the accused.
So on the quantum of sentence, what would be your... Would you be...
pressing for a maximum sentence?
Well, if the court permits me, right, to give my submissions, which I have requested the court to, then I would give my submissions. But to my mind, as human beings and as citizens, right, if we see a child in our presence being attacked even by a dog, we intervene to protect the child. All of us, we would do that. But in this particular instance, having the child in the presence and in his control, he has given narcotics to her, he has assaulted her, and he has caused her death. So this kind of conduct is not the conduct of a good citizen. It is a predatorial conduct. It's the work of a predator, right? And this person has been left with ordinary citizens to move freely for the last 10 years. To my mind, a sentence should be deterrent. But it is ultimately for the courts to decide in their wisdom, and we have to respect that. So various sections of law deal with sentences from 3 years to 10 years. Among these sentences where they have been found guilty. Now, what kind of sentences would be given for every particular section is for the court to decide. Well, in this particular instance, it is up to 10 years. up to 10 years. But we have to look at the mitigating circumstances, and the accused will be given an opportunity through counsel or in person to present the mitigating circumstances. And we would try to put forward the kind of loss and grief that the mother has faced.